Bias in versus debates. Everyone's biased, okay? I'm just gonna say it right now. Everyone's biased. I mean, calling someone biased for a character that won probably means you're biased for the character that lost. That's why you'd even comment that, right? So yeah, everyone is biased. There's no way to avoid it. Bias is basically just having an opinion on which character you like more. There's no way to avoid having bias. But it's when you let that bias take over that it messes up the versus debate. Like, for example, I like Heihachi more than Krillin, right? So that obviously means I'm biased towards Heihachi. But in fictional fights, I had Krillin win. So how on earth do you push that bias down? I mean, even look at this. I had Tails, one of my least favorite characters from my least favorite franchises, beat Coco Bandicoot, one of my favorite characters from one of my most favorite video game franchises. How do I let that happen? It's actually quite simple. You just have to look at yourself and ask, does it really matter? I mean, yeah, a Sonic character beat a Crash character. Woo, but that doesn't mean that Sonic is better or I have to like Sonic more. It's just which character would win in a fight. I remember when I was an obsessed Sonic fanboy back in like 2008, 2009, the early 2010s, very early. And I was super way into Sonic. And then the death battle came out, Mario versus Sonic, where Sonic won for some reason. And I used to be one of those guys that's like, Mario sucks, Sonic's the best. And I would use the death battle as an argument for why the Sonic series is better than the Mario series. It's dumb! Like someone and I would get into an argument, I'd be that angry Sonic troll, like, yeah, Sonic's the best. And by the way, this is all 100% true. I really was that bad of a Sonic fan. I'm not trying to make Sonic fans look bad. Just a lot of them are bad, and I was one of them. So I would use the death battle as a reason for why Sonic's better than Mario. Someone would give me all these good arguments and qualities of why Mario is better. And then I'd just be like, well, Sonic would win in a fight, so Mario sucks. He's a fat, slow Italian plumber. Sonic is fast and cool, so Sonic wins, yay. And it's not fun. Not fun to use bias in versus debates because you end up with stuff like that. Now let's take a look at Jack versus Jasper. I despise Steven Universe, and I love Tekken, yet Jack lost. But I could have easily had Jack win and go, Tekken is better, Jack wins because Tekken is better, and have no real reason. I'd let my bias take over and have Jack win because I think Tekken's better. But then you ask yourself, how in the heck does Jack beating a Steven Universe character make Tekken better than Steven Universe? You just kind of really have to ask yourself, what does your favorite character winning prove? What exactly does it prove? And once you figure out that the answer is nothing, you've finally gotten rid of your bias. Now, there are going to be some characters that you just have a really strong personal attachment to, whether it be nostalgia or you just liking the character a lot. Like, for example, my baby's stalking for Penny and stalking. I can't see her die, so just try and hold off on using those extremely attached characters until you can get over those feelings of personal bias. And when you finally do use them, try to put them in as fair of a fight as possible. I mean, if they win, they win. It doesn't mean you let your bias take over, it just means they won. But if they lose, then they lose. It doesn't mean their opponent is better as a character or their opponent's series is better, it just means that character can beat your character in a fight. And that's okay. I mean, I had Diddy Kong beat Crash Bandicoot in a fight. I love Crash Bandicoot, yet I've never touched a Donkey Kong Country game. I've only looked up walkthroughs and Let's Plays for research and boss battles and footage and all that stuff. I've never actually touched Donkey Kong Country, but yet, off the research, Diddy Kong won Crash Bandicoot, a game that I've been playing since I was 3, and Crash lost. But I still get more enjoyment out of playing Crash, and I don't even feel like wanting to play Donkey Kong Country. It's just not a game I'm interested in. I love Crash Bandicoot, and him losing to Diddy Kong doesn't change my feelings on that. So once you come to terms with all this and you get this sort of mindset, bias just doesn't really affect your results anymore. And remember, to those of you commenting, calling whoever you're butthurt at bias, they are biased, they have their opinions. But it's not like they let their bias take over the fight. And remember, if you're commenting and calling someone biased over who they chose as the winner of the fight, then doesn't that technically make you biased for the loser? So if you're having trouble not letting bias take over, just remember what it proves if you were to let it take over. Nothing.